Hi, welcome to this cabinet vision tutorial. My name's Tayla, and today we're going to be looking at how to create a curved island in cabinet vision. You can see in the 3D example I've got here, we've got a beautiful curved island bench with curved cabinets, and as well as that, a curved bench top to match. So let's jump over into cabinet vision and look at how you can create this in your project. Okay, so I've got my kitchen here, and in the center I've got my peninsula wall ready to go at 3 meters long. I've decided I want my island to be 3 meters by 1 meter overall. So knowing that, I can start by adding in just a typical base cabinet. I'm just going to use one with a single door, but it really doesn't matter which cabinet I use because I'm going to be editing it quite a lot to make it work. So to start with, my cupboard is sitting on the 700 deep side of the island, so it's 665 because it's allowing for a 35 millimeter overhang at the front, and I want to match that on the side. So I'm going to push it in 35 millimeters from the side, and now I want to add extra depth so that I have a single cupboard making that curve along the front and back of the island. So the back side of the island would have 300 millimeters of bench top, but I'm going to take off the 35 mil overhang to keep it consistent. I'm going to make that the depth. And then the outset is going to be negative 265, our 300 minus the overhang. And then for a nice neat join, I want to have my cabinet width be half of the depth. So it's 930. So I'm going to just in here go 930 divided by 2. From the left-hand side. Beautiful, so 465 by 930 deep. So from here I can right click and go edit shape. And if I use the join tool here, I'm gonna set the radius to the width of the cupboard, which was that 465, hit enter to set it. And then to use the join tool, you just click on one line, the line that you first wanna be attaching the join to, and then move your mouse over and click on the second line, and it will create a join in between those two. So same thing on the back, first line, second line, and it creates that nice join. So you can see that this join goes right from the straight line at the back, that point, all the way through. And that's why I've made it the width of it half of the depth of the cupboard. So if I hit return, it will ask me if I want to save it, which I do. But in doing that, it pretty much loses all of the sort of setup information that the cabinet had to start with. So I need to kind of add that back in. So by going to the section and clicking on one of the curves, instead of this being a back part of the cabinet, I want it to be a face so that it will have a kicker attached to it and also that I can put a panel on it. So face, and then the same thing with the other one. I can change it to face, and then if I click on the area and change it from being open to a panel and just match the same on the other side, then when I go to my 3D, you can see this cabinet has got a nice curved panel all the way around it, as well as a matching finish kicker on the front. So that's our curved cabinet. Now we want to have a matching one at the other end, so I could redo all those steps, or I could simply copy and paste this cabinet that I've just made all the adjustments to, bring it in that 35 millimeter overhang from the end. Obviously it's facing the wrong way right now, so the easiest way to change that, just double click into the section view, and under modifications you can use this reverse assembly, which is going to mirror image the assembly. So I'm going to click that, and you can see it flipped up here, and then if we go back we can see it's been flipped. So now it's facing the right way and it's looking perfect. So now all that's left to do is just to add some drawers in between. Beautiful. So I drop my drawers in and I want to have 3 drawer units in between. So I'm just going to copy and paste, and then holding down control, click on all 3 and then right click to equalize their width. Beautiful. And then on the back, I could create or add in some paneling to create an open space for seating. But for this project, we're just going to have a filled in area there. So all we need is a panel, but to have something for it to attach to, I'm going to use a cupboard. Make the depth of it the same depth as the ones adjacent. bringing in 500 from the end so that it sits in between. And then 1992 space to the other end of the island, but then 500 back for the curve to the right. Beautiful. So you can see it's adjusted itself to have three doors, but I really just want to have one flat panel there. So I'm just going to go into section and delete the splits by clicking and deleting, and then put a panel on. Beautiful. So that is all my cabinetry done. And now I just need to add the bench top. So I go to tops and I want it to be attached to the front face. So I just click on the front side to get that red dashed line on the right side. I'm going to manually add this bench top in. So we go new top. I'm going to start with a line box. And from that point there, I'm going to bring it out 3 meters, and it's on the 700 millimeter side of the island. So I can add that in and then just stretch this back line 300 millimeters down. So now I've got 3 meters long, 1 meter wide, and I'm going to use this join tool again. But now that I've got a meter wide, I want the join to be the half of that. So 500 by 500 radius. So type in 500 and hit enter in the radius. And again, just click the two lines either side where you want the join to be, and it will automatically place itself. Beautiful. So I've done that all the way around. Just hit check to make sure everything's good, which is, and then return and save and return again. Beautiful. So now that is my island with the bench top and cabinets all done, ready to go. And if we just have a look at our factory version of this plan, so we can see where our drawer fronts lie. So you can see that the panel on the front of that curve is lining up beautifully with the front of that drawer, and same on the back. So we've got a nice even overhang all the way around our island. And that is really how you draw an island bench with curves by using the join tool. If you have any questions about this or any comments, please leave them below and we'll catch you in the next tutorial. Thank you.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a cabinet vision power user.